something. We got the winning me, Casey Slackin. And I got the gold rapper and baseball boy, Becky. Which
what?
One do you mean, baby? Which
man,
one
you know what? Stupid, man. Whatever, man. Whatever.
Oh, you
nasty. Quit that.
Okay.
Okay.
I need that with
the
two lines
for
sugar. Good
we could
do. Okay.
Mr. Allison. Excuse me. Court.
Hey.
Hey, so, you know it's nowhere I'd rather be. And no one else I'd rather be.
Awkward. Okay, baby. Yeah.
Man, y'all shut up.
That was the ink you was talking about doing.
Nah, bro.
Well, I hope whatever it is, it's a lot smoother approach than that, my brother, because that was lame.
Hold on, man. Lame?
Lame. Loser. La-hoo-za.
Whatever, man. As long as you know me, I ain't never been no lame.
Yeah. Okay. But,
what's
up with this girl?
Well, he does me.
He
just like to play.
I like to play, too.
Hey, you see that dog? Way better player.
Oh, my God.
I'm about to go tear that ass up.
Oh, man. Earl, would you chill? Would you relax? She drunk, man. And if I know Court, she probably over there saying,
girl, you ain't no good. Nigga, they mine. What's up? I can explain, son.
Do you hear yourself?
Do you hear yourself, brother? Look, check this out. I don't care what she got. GED, college degree, HDV. I don't care how many kids she got. 2, 4, 6, 8. I sure you will appreciate it. I don't care what she eats, whether she's vegan or she like me. And I certainly don't care what she's on her last period, because I will always, and I say always, be ready, my brother. All I know right now is I'm about to tear that ass.
Man, Earl, man.
What?
Relax, man. You, first of all, you're nasty. And second, that's why you ain't gonna never have a dead court guy.
And what's that?
Love, understanding, and trust. Plus, I know ways to enter her body without penetration.
You sound stupid. Look, I'm trying to find out how many pimples she got on that booty. And you over here dropping.
Okay, all right. Okay, cool. All right, baby, how's your day? How's your day, babe?
Okay. Jason!
Yeah.
Jason!
Yes, what? What's up, baby?
Baby, why didn't you make the bed?
What you mean?
Baby, why didn't you make the bed? You was the last one in it.
Oh, baby, we're going to get back in the bed tonight when we go to sleep. I mean, that don't make no sense. So baby, what's with them?
What did he do all day?
Oh, hey, mom.
How's my baby doing?
Well, I'm good.
What's wrong? Everything okay?
Oh, yeah. Everything's okay, mom. She's just fussing at me right now.
About what now?
Mom, it's okay. I mean, right now she's fussing at me about not making up the bed this morning.
You got to be kidding me. That's petty as hell. She done let you be a man, but she finds herself by herself.
Mom, it's okay.
It's not okay. I'm still thinking about talking to her about all the other stuff you told me about.
Look, I got to go, okay? I love you.
I love you too. Mama's baby.
Who was that?
Oh, that was Mom.
How Mama Williams doing?
Oh, she doing good. Hey, man, what's up? How you acting up for?
What you mean, what's that? Acting like what? I mean, Jay, did you at least look for a job today?
Well, you know, Earl, he gonna hook me up with a job. Yeah, he gonna hook me up with a job.
Baby.
I'll interview at his job.
Baby. Earl ain't got no job.
Okay, cool. All right, cool. Look, I promise I'm gonna look for a job tomorrow. Okay? I promise I'm gonna look for a job tomorrow.
You're so selfish.
So, tell me what happened, girl.
Girl, I'm not telling you nothing about him and me.
Well, why not? I'm the best friend.
What does that mean, Niecy? I'm not obligated to tell you what's going on.
Yes, you are.
No, I'm not.
Ugh. What kind of best friend are you?
The kind that likes to keep her private life private.
You know what I know, though? It's better to be single and alone than in a relationship and lonely.
Girl, what you talking about? You funny.
See? You judging me.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are. I can wake up alone, but at least I wake up with someone I trust. How you lay there?
What you doing here?
Ugh, what you doing here, nigga?
Niecy.
What? I'm sorry he started it.
But what have I always said about people like that?
That if they push you, don't push back.
Okay. And the Bible?
You have heard that it was said, an eye for an eye, and a tooth for a tooth. If anyone slaps you on the right cheek, you slap their ass back.
Niecy.
What? You have heard that it was said, love your neighbor. Hey, Earl, you miss me?
Yeah.
You came short last time. I ain't like that. Don't do like that again. Y'all done had a moment over here. What did I miss?
No, we didn't have a moment. Of course.
And how was your day, too? A rough day at work or something?
No, Court. I was off. Hey, do y'all mind if I have a conversation in private with
no,
my
No, I ain't going nowhere.
No problem, dog. We got you.
No, I'm
standing
right here.
Right.
You back?
Right.
I'm good.
Niecy, bring your ass.
You ain't my... Don't touch me like that.
I still got
next time.
I'm left there. We just bring that.
I don't need one.
No. What was that about?
What was what about?
Why did your best friend feel the need to mention work to me?
Baby, that's how conversations start. Especially how tight you was with her.
Nah. You've been saying something to her, and I know it.
What are you talking about, Jason? Don't nobody know nothing about what's going on in this house other than me.
Mom, can I call you back?
What's going on? Tell her that's the Jesus, help me.
Hello?
Here.
Look, Ma, you know, I think she told her best friend I'm not working.
Honey, listen, I'll come pack your things up right now, and you can come stay with me.
Mom, it's all right.
It's not all right. I hear the trembling in your voice.
Mommy, it's okay, maybe I'm tripping.
Listen, son, it's not all right. That's your business. Why she feel the need to repeat something that you told someone in your house? You think when you get married, she gonna keep doing that?
Look, I'm good, okay? All right, we are good.
Okay, then.
All right, look.
Hey, let me hit y'all back in a minute, okay? All right. Hey, baby.
Hey, baby. How you doing today? How's your day?
Hey, baby. I'm tired.
Hey, come here.
Work was crazy.
So listen. I was thinking, I was hoping we could go, you know, get some dinner tonight.
Uh-huh. Okay. Well, you feel like cooking it? Okay. What about some Netflix and chill?
Baby, did you not hear anything that I just said? Baby, I said I'm tired.
Yes, I heard you, but did you hear me? I'm trying to spend some time with you, baby.
Baby, do you know my love language?
Yeah, what?
Love language. The things that get me going, the things that speak to my heart and my soul.
Baby, look, I'm just trying to be the man you need, sweetie.
And I'm just trying to teach you how to be the man for me.
But how? When I'm asking to spend time with you, and you keep telling me you're tired.
I'm tired. I'm overwhelmed. I'm tired.
Courtney, I mean, come on now. How hard can your job be, baby? All you do is answer the phones.
Well, you know what? My job would be a lot less stressful if I had some help.
Oh, so now you're telling me the assistant needs an assistant. That's funny.
No, what I'm saying is the assistant needs some assistance around the house. I mean, come on, baby. You shouldn't want me to come on being all stressed out, wondering whether the light bill is paid, whether or not the rent has been paid, whether or not food has been cooked, or even gas in the car. I mean, instead, baby, I should be coming home to a man who's loving, caring, concerned, and has the ability to be a goddamn superhero when he recognizes he needs to save the day. I mean, come on, baby, we're trying to get married.
Whoa. You mean to tell me you saying I'm not man enough?
I said all that, and that's your only response?
No, I heard you, but it sounded like you blaming me, Court.
Yeah, you gotta be kidding me. Look, my dad, he took care of me and my mom. Even when he didn't have the money, he still helped out around the house. He was what kept us afloat there.
Congratulations to your dad, of course. Okay, my dad wasn't it.
Okay. You know what? You know what we need?
I know exactly what we need.
Okay, good. So you know who we need to talk to then?
I know exactly who we need to talk to.
Okay, cool. So then on the count of three, let's say it together.
Let's say it then.
One, two, three. The counselor. Yo, mama! Boy, I'm lost. Yo, mama. What?
You crazy.
15-minute intermission. Make your way to the concession stand.
Alicia Draper, I'm attending Billy Wheaton stage play, Love Language. It's intermission time now, but if you missed the play, I'm trying to tell you, it's phenomenal. It's very funny. It has a lot of great points. The acting is amazing, especially the pastor in the part about the relationships, and everyone should get to know their love language. Great job. I'm Juan, and I'm at the Love Language play, and we're at intermission now, but it was awesome. I'm loving the storyline. It's amazing.
I like it.
Lord, help me with this, man.
Mm-mm. Hey, baby.
Hey, baby, how you doing?
I'm good.
Well, baby, whenever you need to talk, just know you can talk to me, okay? Just don't shut me out. May I ask you a question?
Yeah, what's up?
What did you and Pastor Wilson talk about?
I mean,
if you don't want to tell me, you don't have to. I understand. I can give you a space.
Everything's good. I mean, baby, you know what? I just want. I'm sorry.
Sorry for what, baby?
I just felt like I needed to say it.
Well, I appreciate it. I'm sorry too.
No, not quite. I'm sorry. No, I'm just like my dad.
Wait, what are you talking about, baby? I've never heard you talk about your father.
When that dude brought him up, you know, I never thought I'd cry. You know, especially not my dad's sorrow, mother.
Whoa, wait. I mean, whatever you gotta do, you do it. But can I ask you, what did your mother say after?
I mean, she said that he left when he found out she was pregnant. Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry to hear that, baby.
Nah, don't be sorry for me, Corey. Don't be sorry for me. I turned out good. My mama raised me right.
So you stay on, baby.
Oh, Corey, can you just be serious for a second?
Boy, watch it next time, Chunk. Once you go to work.
Easy, stop.
What?
Girl, we just had our first counseling session today.
What? Tell me everything. Details. What happened? Did he cry? Was he sorry?
Girl, it just ended really weird.
He made you feel like you did something to him, huh?
What? What are you talking about, girl? We did it over here.
Mm-hmm. That's what they do when they feeling the type.
What type?
You know, hurt, caught lying, caught cheating, hell, anything to not make it about them. Men always flip-flop something on the woman to make her feel bad. That's crazy.
All I'm saying is, we good over here, okay?
We're good. Regardless, best friend, I love you. So, you engaged my cute today. I got your back, okay? But I was reading this book, though. It's called Love Languages. And I was thinking, like, I could be in love one
day. Girl, I love that book. Look, I read it, too.
So let me ask you. Do you think Jason knows how to love you?
That's a good question. Mm-hmm. I don't know. All I know, though, is I'm fed up.
Ha! I knew it! When a woman's fed up.
Ready, Court? Something has obviously changed since the last time I saw y'all. You mind telling me what has transpired?
Well, he tried to...
She blamed me. How so?
I mean, you know, after we left, after our last visit, I went home to think about what I was going to do.
All right.
We argued, some words were exchanged, and that was it. I left.
Is this true, Gordon?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, so what words were exchanged?
Well, all I was trying to do was get him to talk, open up a little bit.
Okay.
Some words were exchanged and he left, and he left me there alone and confused.
Alone? You wasn't alone, you were alive. You was with your old nosy friend. And who knows what y'all were talking about? Okay, so where did you go, Jason?
Nowhere really. I just drove around.
And you didn't talk to anybody about your feelings or emotions?
Well, of course I talked to somebody. I mean, it was just so much stuff going through my head.
Okay, so I'm a little confused here. If you two talked, then what brings this distance today?
Oh, I didn't talk to her. She had a nosy friend to talk to. So I called my mom.
Oh my God, see, I'm done.
Jason, please tell me you didn't tell your mom everything.
Well, who else am I supposed to talk to that?
Me, Jason!
Okay, Courtney, don't wait a minute. Obviously, you're upset. Use your words. Tell me how you feel.
That's why I thought if I took my time, that everything in us would be right. No more empty conversations. Next time, I will be totally sure.
And if you just put her first, Yes, sir. That's it. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, have mercy. Yeah, Holy
I'm gonna take you home. I'm gonna put up the earth, yeah. I'm gonna put up the earth, yeah.
Hey. Corey, baby, listen, can I talk to you for a minute?
Oh, now you wanna talk?
Hey, Corey, listen, baby, listen, I'm sorry.
Jason, you embarrassed me!
I know, Corey. I know, and I'm sorry, baby. Listen, I'm just let me talk to you, baby.
No, see, you don't even wanna be no man.
What? Yes, I do, baby, listen, I want to. Listen, baby, come on, listen. Baby, listen, would you listen to me, sweetie? Listen to me, baby. Can't stay away from you too long. Even when I do, I always call. I'm checking on you, make sure you're okay. Be the one to brighten up your day. Oh yeah, and the more I love it all, I love you. Come on, you know I love you, baby. Oh,
came back, and we talked.
I'm impressed. I really am. So Jason, tell me, what is Courtney's love language?
Oh, I know it now. Courtney's love language is words of affirmation and acts of service.
All right, and Courtney, what is Jason's love language?
Quality time and words of affirmation.
That's it, baby.
All right. Seems like you two put your best foot forward.
Yes, you know, Pastor, I looked at her and I realized I almost lost her.
My Lord. Mm-hmm. Gift worth keeping. Yes. I'm not mad. All right, well, Jason, let me ask you this.
Yes.
How's your mom think?
Oh, well, you know, Court and mom met, and Court told my mom that she wanted me as a husband. And she said that my mom didn't have to worry because she knew how to take care of a man by watching her mom take care of her dad, and vice versa. And she told mom that if she had any questions concerning taking care of me,
that I would give her a call.
All right. That was real good. Go ahead, Courtney. That was real good. Okay, Jason, well, tell me about this. What about your dad?
I gave him a call. I left him a message. I hadn't heard anything, but, you know, it's all good. I'm moving on.
Okay. Well, hopefully you get to have that face-to-face real soon. Yeah, we'll work on that. All right. I have you two grown.
Yes. And I've been working. All right. I've been straightening up the place.
All right.
And I have definitely been making the bed.
That's what I'm talking about. Making the bed. Good thing, sir. All right. Well, that's good. Well, listen. If you need my, assistance with anything, or you need my recommendation for marriage, you got my blessing.
Well, aren't you licensed to marry?
Yeah, but no.
What, Doc? I mean, can you marry us if you want to do this, baby?
Yeah.
Oh, well, son, it's not that simple. I mean, we need a witness.
We need a witness.
Line blinking on me. Hello? Yeah, come on up, nephew. All right.
That's a witness, huh? Is it?
No, that's not.
Oh, now, come on now. You said we needed a witness, and look what God did. God gave us a witness, huh? So you want to do this,
baby? Yeah, but we need a witness, though, baby.
Come on in, nephew.
All right, Lucy, I love you. Yeah. Jay! Yo, what up, boy? How you feeling, man? What you doing here?
No, what you doing here?
Rapping my uncle, man.
Your uncle?
Yeah.
It's your uncle. Hey, Master, this is my best friend. This is my homeboy. Can he be our witness?
Whoa, no, I didn't see nothing, man. Witness or nothing. Oh,
well, they want me to marry.
Oh. Here?
Yeah.
Now.
Yeah. Yes, Earl.
You good with this?
Yes.
All right, dude, what I gotta do?
All right, well, come stand over here. Y'all two stand right here. Lord heaven. Okay. Let me get my Bible. Dearly beloved, we gathered here in the sight of God and Earl. Join us too. And I look in your eyes, there I see all that you need me to. Love that we share makes life so sweet. Heaven will always be holding you close through the night. I need you, yeah. And I look in your eyes, there I see
Stand there and look at me in my face.
and tell me a bull-faced lie, and then you gonna blame my mama?
Look. Nothing else I can really say. I'm sorry. Jason. I'm sorry. Quite some time. Hope everything's all right. Hope she's feeding you your favorite meal. If not, then you always come home with me. Zebulon Ellis. Yeah. Now, I ain't trying to, you know, I didn't know him. I went to Atlanta when I did our stage play down there, and a friend of ours introduced me to him. And ever since then, I was following him. Then I put two and two together, because I was watching Tyler Perry stuff, and I was like, that's the same dude. And ever since then, man, that's last year, we've been cool, and I was like, I gotta get him in the production. But this guy is crazy. Love him where?
Love him!
Love you. Love you. Love you. Been in my productions before, man. And when they said that, hey, we need some extra people, I was like, man, I know the person called. And soon as I sent her a text, she said, yes, what time I gotta be there? And she's been here like a trooper, man. I thank you, love you. Thank you. Hey, let me tell you a story, though. All right, this is David Gully. David Gully, let me tell you what happened. He DM'd me on last Saturday and was like, man, I want to be in one of your productions. And I was like, we were just looking for an extra, you know, for a guy just to fill in rehearsals. So I asked him, I said, have you ever acted before? He said, yes. I said, can you audition? He said, yes. I said, can you do it tomorrow? He said, yes. He came into audition, auditioned for Dad, right? And we was like, okay. So when we got to rehearsal, you know, he was filling in for the women. And like he did it so good. I pulled the director aside and was like, he give me the mama. And she was like, nah. I said, the beard, everything. Keep everything. Keep everything. And man, I thank you, man, for just jumping in. Micah Dixon. Now, this is Micah's first stage play. The whole time she kept saying, I don't know, I never did it before. And I was like, man, you are the natural. And in rehearsals, man, she was killing it, man, and it resonated on stage. Thank you, Micah. Thank you. All right, now here's the story. So here's Tiffany Allison. Now, Tiffany Allison, I've been knowing Tiffany, man, since I was, you know, we were going to church a long, long time ago. And she's been in the movie, the last stage plays, tours, all that, right? So this time, you know, I casted Latavia Roberson, right? Latavia Roberson from Destiny's Child. So everything was great. Everything was cool. I'm in contact with her and it was all good. So then on Monday, a couple days ago, like Monday. Monday, her manager, I've never talked to, was like, hey, I got bad news. Latavia came to the show. She has to have emergency oral surgery. I'm like, awesome. She had to have emergency oral surgery, right? So I'm like, what? So I called the manager back and I was like, and my greatest fear since dealing with celebrity talent was this. Hey, I can't do it. So in my mind, so for 20 minutes I panicked. I'm like, I promoted this woman and I don't know who's coming out to see her, but I promoted this woman. And you know, you want things to go as planned. So I talked to this dude and he was like, yeah, you know, she wanted to call you personally, but I told her, no, don't do it. Don't go to her Instagram. Don't look at nothing since Monday. I don't want y'all to get mad. Cause she been posting. I don't see nothing wrong with her, but y'all more than welcome to, you know, go on her page and say hello. Say hello, we missed you in Cleveland. But, so that was that, man. So again, I panicked. I did not know what to do, because it's like, man, rehearsal start, you know, she's supposed to be on the plane. So, you know, I was like, I got a couple of people I can call, but I got another plane ticket. That's another, you know, adjustment schedule for this week. So I was like, I need somebody here, Tiffany. Because not only that, you have to learn this role, like now. You know what I'm saying? Absolutely. Whatever you gotta do, we have to do it now. I text her, I said, WYD. About 5 minutes later, she texts back, nothing, what's up? I just wanna let you know I'm so proud of you. You're doing great things. I'm so happy for you. And I was like, thank you. What you doing? And she like, nothing, but I do want to audition for the next one. I said, why audition when you can be in this one? And she was like, okay, what you want me to do? I was like, the lead. She said, what? Hold on, send me the script. And then it's been that downhill, man. And thank you, sir. We got Archie Berwick. And Archie was in my the first stage play I did when I toured. And that was his very first time doing stage plays. And I didn't know him. But ever since then, he has moved to New York and started doing other things. Then he moved to Philly and he's working with all the Philadelphia sports teams and all the other stuff. And, you know, I'm so grateful that he was able to just, you know, put us in the mix up. Thank you. And his schedule, you know, was a conflict, you know, so cool. So I hit his manager this time, and it was all good. And man, this dude, man, like, he was in, okay, so I watched a lot of Tyler Perry, and he is, like, 3/4 of it, all of them. And like, his acting is just phenomenal. His singing is phenomenal. And I was like, I gotta work with this dude. Not only that, though, we similar, you know what I'm saying? So I was like, I gotta work with him. And man, and I didn't know that those two knew each other. And man, it's been great, man. This whole journey has been great. You know, I still have my man, Marlon Martin, from stage manager since 2012. This production has been directed by someone new. To us, but not definitely not new to the theater world. Colleen Longshaw. Now let me tell you why her. She is dynamic in the theater, right? This ain't theater. This is stage play. Like this whole different world. So I was like, I need someone from that side to come over here and introduce us and help us grow. And she is phenomenal, man. As you know, the set has been built by GoPay Customs, Shore, Blade. He had help with Richard Calhoun. And man, my cousin introduced us, MC Brains. And hair and makeup, last but not least, hair and makeup has been done by Leslie Saunders. And she's been with us since 2012 too, man. So I thank you all for pushing aside your Sunday, man. I know it's kind of like a Sunday, but it's a Sunday. Thank you. We're going to be in the lobby saying hello to you all and good night and all that. And yes, I was about to. A special thanks to TV20. Thank you. You don't want to know, but I just thank you all, man, because this has been a trying time for all of us, man. All of us. All of us. All of us. God is good. God is good. As you know, man, every time you try to do something, step out and do something on faith and believe that you have what it takes,
something always comes. And it seems like, man, it's getting greater and greater. Greater and greater, heavier and heavier, man. But I thank God, man, that we was able to stand and test. Each and every one of us, man, been through something within these last 6 months that should have taken us out and said, I can do this, I don't want to do this. Let me scoot to the side, let somebody else do it. I didn't want to do it. But, man, God is good. So I see y'all in the lobby, man. Thank you.
I'm so very proud of you. You are one of my biggest inspirations. I love you from a little sister to a big brother. You are awesome. I love your work. You're so hardworking and determined. Nothing but great things. Every time I come and see a play, I enjoy it. Carson enjoys it. He loves it, all the action. So very proud of you. I love you from the bottom of my heart. I love you so much. And I'm so very proud of you and happy for you. Nothing but great things, and I love you. Carson, you want to tell Uncle Level? We love you.
Hey, what's going on? My name is Archie. I play Earl in the Love Language, man. We had a fabulous time. Thank you to everybody for coming out. We laughed, we cried, and we thought about love, because love is what it's all about. I hope you all learned something, man, and see y'all next time. Peace.
I'm Lovey Weir, and I was a part of Love Language by Philly Weeden. Awesome, awesome play. Good job to all of the cast members. Philly, your writing is phenomenal. Thank you for bringing the awareness that although we're colored black people, we still need marriage counseling. It helps because we don't know the person who we love language. And it is just an awareness for us to get to know each other and what makes each other happy so that we can have long marriages like our grandparents did. Thank you everyone that came. Awesome job. Thank you, Philly. Keep doing your thing. I appreciate you. And thank you to the staff.
By Philly Weeden. I actually purchased a ticket for the last play, and my job called me once I arrived to the play and I had to leave. So this is my second attempt, but my first actual play was phenomenal. I'm very proud of Philly. I champion everything that he's doing right now, and as somebody making lots of steps in my personal life to achieve similar outcomes, it's exciting to see someone take hold, overcome the obstacles, remain persistent, and have a beautiful outcome like this. So keep doing what you're doing. I love your work. I support it. I'm happy for you.
Really enjoyed the play. It was awesome. It was wonderful. Make you want to learn about love language.
Really enjoyed the play. Great job once again, Philly Weeden. It made you laugh. It made you cry. It was so beautiful.
If it's a book, I got to read it.
It was phenomenal.
Absolutely great.
It was good for me to get a chance to sit there and watch it as I learned how to do some love language to love my lovely lady a lot harder and a lot better. Yeah. So I thank you for this message, Philly. I appreciate it, bro. Always rocking with you.
What's up, Philly Weeden? It's Vaughn Glover here, man. Came out to support you, as we said, finally, you know. I got up off myself, nothing was going on. I really enjoyed the play tonight, and I hope one day, Philly Weeden, to be involved helping you take this to bigger and better places. Much love to you, brother. Peace.
Oh, hey. You don't know, babe.
you hold me and kiss me slowly, it's the sweetest thing. And it don't change. If I had it my way, you would know that you are. You're the coffee that I need in the morning. You're my sunshine in the rain when it's pouring. Won't you give yourself to me? Give it all. I just wanna see. I just wanna see how beautiful you are. You know that I see it. I know you're a star. Where you go, I'll follow. No matter how far. If life is a movie, oh, you're the best part. Oh, you're the best part. Oh, best part.
Is this sunrise and those brown eyes? Yes, you're the one that I desire. So nice.
Yo, what's up? It's your radio babe, Micah Dixon. Just finished up the love language. It was amazing, emotional. Ask yourself, what is your love language, okay? Read the book, The Five Love Languages, and figure out what is your love language. It's amazing. Funny, hilarious, one time for Lee Weeden, one time for, what is this name again? Oh, Tony Hightower, for Tiffany, Allison, and everybody else in the cast, and for you watching this and coming out. I love you.
Yo, this is my first time working with Philly Weeden. I have had a ball. My name is Tony Hightower, man. We just did our thing, Love Language. Yo, man, it was a killer play. We had a wonderful audience. We had a wonderful time, man. Zebulon Ellis, me, you know, we both from Atlanta, so we both knew each other before this. This is both our first time working with Philly. And like, you know, great playwright. Play right, but outside of that, just cool people, man. And you know, look forward to seeing more. Look out for that, cause we're gonna do some more together, man. Check it out. I'm sure it's gonna come back. Peace.
Hi, my name is Tiffany Renee Allison. We just finished Love Language. Oh my goodness, what an amazing show! If you missed it, you missed something pretty awesome. I just want to say, from Philly Weeden Productions, laugh, cry, think, and stay tuned for what's coming next.
All right, this is Marlon Martin, stage manager for Philly Weeden's stage play, Love Languages. We've been on this road for about 6 years now. It's been going strong, and we just keep elevating, we're trying to push it up. We want to thank everybody who came up, showed us love, and been supporting by the Love, Cry, Think Productions from day one. We out of here. Peace. Yeah.